clean leather. Now, by that I mean your car, your shoes, your clothes, your purses, your furniture, anything that's leather. I'm going to show you how to clean it. And it's easier than you think. First of all, if you have a bar of Dove soap, you have a great cleaner for leather. Take a microfiber cloth, wet it, work in your Dove soap just like that, get it all sudsed up, and then start and wash. This is great for the car. When you're done, go back and buff it. You don't have to rinse. Go back and buff it with a dry microfiber cloth, and that will take care of it for you 100%. Now, another cleaner you can make is take a couple of cups of warm water, put them in a spray bottle, add in about 2 teaspoons of vinegar, and then add some good squirts of either shampoo or a mild liquid soap. Spray that onto any leather you have and buff with a microfiber cloth. Now, one I particularly like for furniture is using a facial cleaner. Now, this is a facial cleaner that I like at home and I use myself. So I take one part of this and I take 8 parts of water and I put it in a spray bottle. Then again, I'm going to squirt it on things like my leather shoes, my clothes, my purses, even furniture, and buff with a microfiber cloth. Now, when you're cleaning leather, make sure you're trying these things in an inconspicuous spot first, because we want to do no harm, and that's the most important thing. So try it on the back of the couch or something. Now, if you want a product you can buy, I love Leather CPR. You can buy this at Bed Bath & Beyond, at Home Depot, on Amazon, any of those places. I have no interest in this product or anything. I'm not recommending it because I get paid. I've been talking about it for 15 years. I've never found a better product, and it's for all colors of leather. Now, what else can you do if you have stains on leather? And this you definitely want to try in an inconspicuous spot. You're going to take one part of lemon juice. It can be the whole lemon. It can be juice in a jar. One part of cream of tartar, and that's in the spice aisle. You'll work that in, let it sit a few minutes, and then rinse it off. But again, make sure you try it in an inconspicuous spot. If you have ink on anything that's leather, you can try some rubbing alcohol on a Q-tip, or you can try Amadex. Now, Amadex will even take out marker, and you get this at office supply stores, on Amazon, places like that. It is one of the best ink removers I have ever used. Now, do you want to condition your leather, which is what I do to this jacket every year, and I have had this, I bet, 10 years. What I did is I take one part of white vinegar, 2 parts of olive oil, and I put it in a jar with a good lid on it, and you'll want to label it. Before you use it, shake it really, really good. Put a little on a cloth, work it in, and I let it sit for about an hour or two to really get it in condition. Then I buff it really well with a dry microfiber cloth. Now, if you like the really natural things and you want to use oil on your leather, use coconut oil. It works great for conditioning, and coconut oil never turns rancid, and that's pretty important because you don't want that nasty smell. Again, work it on and then buff it off. So guys, if you're looking for a copy of all of this, go to queenofclean.com. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. There's hundreds of videos on there. Check me out at Real Queen of Clean on Facebook and Instagram. And thanks for talking dirty with the Queen of Clean.